Hello all, this is James Johnson, a.k.a. Sulfur Blade, and I am back here with the political process. Before I dive into the political process, I just want to remind everyone that my channel is for adults, so if you're under the age of 13, please exit stage right. With that being said, let's jump on in. So, at this point, I've been thinking about where to go with the game. I do want to see just how much I can cut down the spending. So in this year, I'm going to be going back through the policies to see what things I may not have been able to get passed in the first year. Since we still have a Republican president and a Republican Senate, I need to take advantage of that situation. At least I think we still have a Republican Senate. We do. Okay, so still need to capitalize on this as much as I possibly can. Then after I capitalize it and I have really decapitated all the spending that I logically can, at that point, the deficit's still going to be completely out of whack because there's nothing I can do about the spending on things like defense and even the health and labor, the $2 trillion health and labor section of the budget that you just can't seem to make any logical effect on. So I've kind of given up on the concept of balancing the budget, at least for this playthrough. I might do another playthrough where I start as a quote-unquote Democrat. I bust the taxes out crazy right off the get-go. We're talking like 50% across the board, as well as increasing Social Security and other taxes, right? Then turning around and becoming a Republican again. And then trying to shrink spending. See if I can make that work. It might sound a little gamey, but it may possibly allow me to get a budget in deficit removed or affected enough to where it might make a difference. But in that situation, I think I need to get elected to the House, like, right away, as soon as the game starts, so that I can get to that deficit before it spirals out of control. Like, right now, the deficit has pretty much spiraled out of control. But I do want to still continue this particular playthrough because, well, I haven't become Speaker of the House yet, and I haven't become President. And so I feel like I'll be a fairly young speaker, and that'll be a good spot to launch a campaign for presidency from, which is, I guess, the new goal of this particular playthrough. So anyway, let's get into the game. Low performing school grants. Didn't I get rid of this one? think we're finished gutting education now. That'll be completely gone. That's going to be knocked down to 30%, which I'm happy with. That's gone. I'm fine with preschool, actually. I don't want to affect food programs. Nor energy. Didn't I get rid of rural rent assistance? I thought I tried to access one. No Republican running against me, that's excellent. Thought I got rid of community development grants, too. Huh? I swear we got rid of this. What was HR 3 that didn't make it out of committee? I thought I had it set to 30. Rural rent assistance. Okay, Senate committee is screwing us on HR3. Got it. HR4 shot down in committee. Same 10 to 12 vote. Senate. All right, I'm done trying to push bills. So long as you don't anger your base or lose too many independents, you will win. Luciano's doing well. Parker Howe, Sandoval. Military budget. fundraiser with the president. Excellent. You've already impressed quite a lot in your political career. I'm impressed. So, let me get this straight. My caucus and party leader both said, go ahead and increase minimum wage? Is this a new game? Oh, I can increase my political points for fundraising for the party. Interesting. closer election than usual, but then I'm not as popular as usual. Parker Howe, sweet. Luciano, good. You have been minority leader. Ah, shit. They've chosen you to serve as their leader in house. They will now look to you for guidance on all legislative decisions. This position will allow you to influence every representative in your party, so long as you have a good relationship with their caucus. National law is taking effect this year. Grants to improve low-performing schools eliminated. Higher education grants decreased. Public housing, eliminate public housing program. Rural rent assistance decreased. Huh, there's less poverty. Cut so many things, and yet I can't get the expenditures down. Gah. Oh well. increase Social Security eligibility age from 66 to 70. Thought I already raised it to 69. Some weird stuff going on there. Democrats proposing bills and then opposing the bill they proposed. Oh wow, we have lost a lot of seats. Senate's good though. How did eligibility rates get that high? President will veto all that crap. Holy cats, we managed to lower the defense appropriation bill? What? That's amazing. How did it get that high? No Republicans. Good. Oh yeah, I'm campaigning. Graphics are in my favor. I've won the primary. Blah 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 blah. It bothers me we're here begging for money rather than working on policies to improve the lives of our constituents. How am I supposed to do my job as a politician if I'm spending all my time asking for money? rally with Senate candidate Denzel Newman. Of course. Four weeks yet. Take that, Blake Becker. We lost Ohio. We lost Florida. Got Missouri. No Pennsylvania. Texas. Oh, I suppose we have to turn until we get to... Speaker! Woo! Yeah! We have accomplished becoming Speaker of the House. Years of effort and dedication have earned you the respect of your fellow politicians. House representatives have chosen you to serve as their leader in the House. They will look to you for guidance on all legislative decisions. This position will allow you to influence every representative in the House, including the minority party, so long as you have a good relationship with their caucus. The Senate is Republican, the House is Republican, and the President is back to being a damn Democrat. But this is a good place to probably end it, as the next episode will probably be me just going through this term and then the next term. So I have two terms to go through, which will equal 4 years of this presidency. And then it's off to run for president myself. Anyway, I am James Johnson, a.k.a. Software Blade. This is my content. Hopefully you're enjoying it. If so, please leave a like and subscribe. And until the next time, all, peace.